In some scenarios, you might wish to control a track's routing options, meaning the input and especially the output destination of the track signal. This may be useful, for example, when you want to group various tracks together to control their overall level or EQ. Or you might wish to record the output of various tracks into a new audio track, or perhaps send the signal from various tracks to an effect. You can control each track's input-output settings via the mixer. This is where you can decide to route a track to another. For example, let's take a look at applying a send effect. Send effects, as opposed to insert effects, which affect the entirety of the track signal, allow you, for instance, to have a single reverb effect and send different amounts of your tracks to it. Let's see a quick example of this to clarify the difference. Let's apply a reverb to our guitar track here, first as an insert effect and then as a send effect. To apply a reverb as an insert effect, all you need to do is pick the effect from the track's effects panel. This will let you choose an effect to apply, which will affect the entire signal, or better, the amount set by the dry and wet parameters. You can also add effects using sends. A send allows you to send a track signal to an auxiliary track, which will be the host of the insert effect. This allows you to send different tracks to the same effect in different amounts, controlled by the send amount knob. To route a track to a send, open the mixer. Then click Add a new send icon on the track we wish to send. As you can see, Entra created this auxiliary track, which will host our reverb effect. We give the reverb 100% wet and 0% dry signal, since the dry component will be coming from our original track, and the auxiliary track will only provide the signal with the effect applied. We can now control the reverb amount using track 1's send knob.